Dear students, welcome to another lecture in Industrial Engineering and Quality Control. Today we are starting the third chapter, which is ergonomics. Now, when you say ergonomics, you see this word is derived from two different words of Greek language. One word is ergon. Ergon, that means work. And another word is nomos, that means natural laws. So ergonomics means the natural laws of work. Okay, so the ergonomics is, when you say ergonomics, it is the study of man in relation to his work. The word ergonomics is used in the the continent of Europe, whereas in America and some other countries it is called human engineering, but in our country it is more famous as ergonomics. Okay, anyway, so ergonomics or human engineering, this is concerned with the man machine system, how man and the machine, you know, how they interact with each other. No, this is the study of this is ergonomics. So ergonomics, when we say ergonomics, this study or this science, you can say it is a multidisciplinary science. It comprises of subjects like anatomy. There's a doctors and others study anatomy. The anatomy means the body, how the body is made and how the muscles are and other things, I think. Okay, then psychology, in Marathi Manas Shastra. Then physiology, sociology, engineering, anthropology, physics, medicine, and so many different types of disciplines, you know. It takes a little from all these subjects, and this multidisciplinary topic ergonomics, you know, has come into the picture. Now, why are we studying ergonomics? Because, you know, you see, if you remember, in design of machine elements last semester also you have studied ergonomics, but in a brief way. So because it is concerned with the designing also, but now we are studying as part of industrial engineering, because arranging of the workplaces also ergonomics is involved in. So ergonomics is the process of designing or arranging workplaces and products and systems so that they fit the people. People means now who are operating the machines. Either the operators or the workers or whoever is using them. You know, even if you talk about automobile, if a car, you know, you may be the driver. In the motorcycle, you may be riding it. In a cycle, you know, everywhere. Okay, even things like, you know, sitting in a chair, sofa, dining table. Okay, see how these operators or workers or users, they are fitting into these into their workplaces, into their products, into their systems. In other words, ergonomics is the science of work which deals with the relationship between man and his working environment. It implies fitting the job to the worker. If you see about the chairs, how many different types of chairs are there? See, the sofa in your drawing room is different, its height is different, its dimensions are different, that the chair that you are sitting at the dining table is different, the chair that you use in the office table is different, then the chair or the bench that you use in the classroom is different.
Okay.
And the chairs that nursery students use are different than the chairs that college students use are different. Is it not? You see, ergonomics plays a role in all that. Okay. We will see in detail later. Ergonomics focuses on human beings and their interaction with products, environment facilities, surrounding workplace, working conditions, that is an environment, while doing the work. And also when I am talking about chairs, seats. Seat of a motorcycle is different, seat of a motorcycle is different, seat of a car is different, seat that is there in a truck, you know, how a truck driver sits, all those are different, you see. Okay. Now, let us see. Now, ergonomics helps. Why are we studying ergonomics? Because it improves the efficiency, the reliability, and the productivity. If you are of the man-machine system, efficiency of man-machine system. You know, if you are sitting in front of a computer, if you are sitting in front of a laptop, okay, you see, ergonomics helps to improve the efficiency. Ergonomics helps to improve the reliability of your working and your productivity. See, these ergonomics helps. See, I say even the buttons on the keyboard, are designed from ergonomic point of view. Okay. To study the effect of health and safety of human beings, also, ergonomics we study. Ergonomics helps to study the effects of health of the environment or the system and the safety of human beings. You know, it helps us, it gives us an idea. Okay. Bad working conditions affect the productivity adversely. Say, bad working conditions means, it is, very noisy environment, sound pollution if it is there, or the light is not proper, or the temperature is not proper, very sultry and or very humid situation, okay, where the sweat also is not, it is drying. In such cases, you cannot productively work. Okay, whereas good working conditions make the workers to make more take more interest in their job. Naturally, that's why some people were saying why managers are given AC rooms, because if you make them comfortable, if they are not bothered about the discomfort that the outside environment creates, they'll be able to pay more attention and they'll be able to give you more output, more work. Okay, that's why they are provided. Nowadays so many IT people, they all may be working in AC cabins only. Okay, because it brings out the best out of them. Okay, those are the days, when we were small people, were not like that. They used to have a kind of sadistic happiness when others are suffering. But if you want to extract work from others, give them good working conditions. Okay, then interest of workers in the job to a greater extent depends on how comfortable and safe the working place is. While designing a workplace, various factors need to be considered. Ergonomics considers all such factors and deals with the relationship between man and his workplace so that the best possible workplace can be designed. You see, this is from the design point of view we are talking. Now, thus the ergonomic information applied to design ensures comfort, safety, etc. to the human beings due to best possible environments and designs prepared. Now, even as a process engineer, you should be able to, you know, design your process in such a way that the worker and his machine, they are that man-machine system, you know, they are made for each other, comfortable, you know, it bring, you know, he feels happy being there in front of that machine, you know. Otherwise, no, it should not be that, you know, he hates his machine, he gets nightmares about the, you know, working conditions. In the night also, in dreams also, you know, that that is a horrible workplace is coming. You know, it should not be like that. It should be a pleasant feeling for him. He should feel that this is my, you know, workplace, you know, where I like to work, you know. While designing machines and environment for human use, it is important to realize that man has a limited power. Hence, the designer should design the most suitable machines equipment considering human health and efficiency. Most suitable workplace and most suitable machine reduces the physical and mental strains caused to the worker while carrying out the work. You see, there are limits for human beings. You know, a human being, you know, is there, the, you know, for his vision there are limits, for his hearing there are limits, for his exerting pressure, for applying forces, for lifting loads, everything there is a limit. You know, man has limited power. You see, we don't have, you know, so much power. That's why we have designed machines. If everything is so easy, why would man design machines? He would not. Okay, but we have limited power. Therefore, no, everything that we are doing, you know, we should reduce the physical and mental strains caused for the worker. You know, in the olden days, you know, the steering wheel of the car, you know, it used to be very difficult to turn, especially trucks and buses, you know, for taking a turn, other things, you know, the people, the drivers used to drive and, you know, their shoulders used to pain. But nowadays, you know, they have provided the power steering, okay, for that also mechanized steering. It's not difficult now. So, wow, what are we doing? We are making things comfortable. You know, in the olden days, it used to be, you know, such a hot and humid, cabin for the truck driver. Nowadays, even in trucks, ACs they are providing so that he may comfortably drive. Okay. Ergonomics discovers information about human behavior, limitations, and other characteristics. This information is applied to design of tools, designs of machines, designs of systems, design of tasks, design of jobs, design of environments for productive, safe and comfortable and effective human use. Ultimately, what your goal is, you know, you should make the machine and man to fit each other, you know, and You see, even know how you, the operating system of a computer, that is also ergonomically designed. You know, Microsoft people, they are making Windows means, you know, they have even the color code, color system and other things. So much of research has gone into it. You see, it is not that they are only employing software engineers. They employ, you know, sound engineers. They employ color engineers, you know, and so many other people, you know. See, that's why, you know, see, such colors, you know, Windows operating system has, so that, you know, it is not a strain for the eye of the human being. For so many hours, you know, if you are sitting in front of the computer also, you know, your eyes will not feel that much strained. You see, some of the other companies also make software who don't have this comfort of so much of research into these colors, sounds, and other things. So they give such colors for their software that the user finds it very difficult to work for long duration in that software. Okay, see people in these multinational companies and people who are into businesses which are spanning for so many decades, and people who are in the topmost companies in the world, they have taken care about minute things like this also. Okay, even Google and other things, how many things they think of, Okay, anyway, thus ergonomics improves the performance of overall system by optimizing the compatibility of man-machine system. In India, Indian people, their built up, their height, their weight, are different. Their working environment is different. Their comfort conditions are different. Whereas if you see Europeans or Americans, their built up is different. They are much taller there compared to Indians. Okay. And, if you are making seats for them, you have to consider how tall they are, what should be the height of the chairs and other things. All those things you have to consider depending upon the body sizes also. Okay. What we are doing is, ergonomics is improving the performance of overall system by optimizing compatibility of man and machine system. Okay, in general, the scope and objective of ergonomics is designing for human use and optimizing working and living conditions. So this is the scope. We have to design systems for human use and optimizing working and living conditions. Okay. Now, ergonomics combines the knowledge of a physiologist, a psychologist, and anatomist, an engineer, and an anthropologist. Okay, because we already said, so many disciplines it is taking. So this is a multidisciplinary science or multidisciplinary topic. Okay, so therefore ergonomics. Now here there is a definition given. It is defined as the relationship between man and machine, equipment, facilities, workplace, occupation, etc., and the application of anatomical, physiological, and psychological principles to solve problems arriving from man-machine relationship. Okay, this is the definition. You can learn it. Okay, another definition also is there. Ergonomics also can be defined as a systematic study of relationship between man or people and their occupation. In their occupation, they have equipment and their working environment. For the purpose of, why are we making that systematic study of this relationship between people and the equipment? To increase the human efficiency and to increase the productivity. Okay, removing those features of design which turn to cause inefficiency and physical disability. You see, whichever is causing inefficiency should remove, whichever is causing physical disability or making you to be unproductive, such things should be removed, and whatever increases the efficiency, whatever increases the productivity, such things should be incorporated. Okay, for that, whatever study we are systematically studying is ergonomics. Okay. Now, various disciplines in ergonomics. is the anatomy. Anatomy, study of body dimensions and relations for work design. Body means human body. Human body's dimensions. That means, you know, how if your hand is there, how big it is. Your forearm, how big it is. You know, your shoulders, your chest, your seat, your knees, how tall they are, you know, all those things. Then anthropometry, information on body size. This is body dimension, this is body size. Okay, field of movement, field of view, speed of response, forces exerted. Is a force exerted? You know, that's why we are, I was asking in machine design, how much a hand, with the hand, how much a man will be able to lift, how much load he'll be able to lift. With a hand, you know, normally we, on an average, we say around 30 kgs or 3000 newtons of load he'll be able to lift. That's what we were saying. Okay, whereas with the foot, how, you know, some of the pedals and other things are operated by foot. Okay, how many kgs of force you'll be able to apply with the foot. Okay, maybe around 50 or 60 kgs. That means 500 to 600 newtons you'll be able to exert force with the leg. Okay, then physiology. Study of man and his working condition, working environment, senses, etc. Physiology. Then psychology. Psychology, knowledge of brain, nervous system, human behavior, mental processes, skills of human beings, etc. Engineering design. Design of work system suitable to worker. Then industrial hygiene. Occupational hazards and health of worker. You know, these are the various disciplines that are that have helped ergonomics to evolve, and it has evolved as a multidisciplinary subject. Okay, now scope of ergonomics study. The topics included in ergonomic studies are anthropometry, design of man-machine systems, energy expenditure in hand and foot operations, design of controls. You know, controls means, you know, you either it can be push buttons or it can be joysticks, like, you know, your gear levers and other things. You know, you see, even the gear lever, how big it should be, you know, all those things. So the design of hand levers and hand wheels, even steering wheel of car, the handle of two wheelers and other things. Design of displays, you know, how much eye with eye, what distance you'll be able to see, how big should be the font, what color it should be the font, how thick it should be, and all those things. And then layout of instrument dials, display panels for accurate perception by the operator. Perception means, you know, they should be able to clearly read without any strain to the eyes or to the body. Okay, design of workplace, like lighting, noise, climate conditions in machine environment, that is atmospheric conditions surrounding the workplace. Then control of physical workload and accidents, fatigue, and safety. For all these things, no, we consider the ergonomic study is there, is done. That is the scope of the ergonomic study. And then now tasks or activities of ergonomics. To develop the most comfortable working conditions for the worker with respect to lighting, climate, ventilation, noise level, temperature, humidity. See, all these are coming. Lighting. You know, proper lighting should be there if in the working place. If a person is working on a lathe machine, proper lighting should be there. Okay, and climate should be, he should feel comfortable in that climate. Okay, the proper ventilation, air circulation, and other things should be there. Then noise levels should be bearable for the, you see, our ears. No, if excessive, if people who are working in very high decibel levels, you know, it is found that after some day, some years of working in such a thing, they go deaf. Okay, so it affects the body. Then temperature, the humidity. Humidity means the water content in the air, you know. That's how, you know, if humidity in the water, in the air, you know, water content in the air is less, then your sweat can be easily absorbed. Otherwise, no, if it is already saturated, the sweat will not evaporate, you know, from the body. It will be simply trickling down your body, and you'll feel very uncomfortable. Okay, to reduce the physical workload, in particular in hot environments, these are the tasks, you know, of ergonomics. Say the people whoever are doing this study of ergonomics and all this, they should pay attention to these things. To improve working posture. Posture means, you know, how they are sitting. Is he sitting or standing, in what position, or if they are reaching out to something, if they are catching hold of something, how, in what posture they should stretch and catch, you know. And to reduce the effort of certain movements while, you know, applying some forces, or to catch something, to pull something, or to push something, all those things. To, you know, how, what postures, and how to reduce the efforts, you know, all those things you should consider. To facilitate psychosensorial functions in reading instrument displays. So in reading instrument displays, you know, sometimes you may read wrongly. Okay, earlier, you know, all analog systems were there. Now digital systems have come, and we read about parallax error and other things. And also some of the things, some of the displays, you know, you see, you know, from distance also you should be able to see, you know, at what distance you'll be able to see what should be the color coding, what should be the font size, which type of font it should be, you know, so that, you know, he will not be confused with some other letters or some other digits. Okay, to make the handling of machine levers and controls easier. Levers and controls, the handling of those things should be easy. See, if it is a small child handling and a grown-up man handling, you see, the levers won't be same. You see, for small things, you know, small cars and see, remote cars, you know, the small children operate, how big their levers are. You know, the same things, you know, if you are operating in the lathe machine, milling machine, how those levers are. You see, because the person has grown up, and his hands dimensions are different now, and the forces that he can exert are different. Okay, to make better use of spontaneous and stereotyped reflexes, that is repeated or repeatable reflexes. You know, to make better use of those spontaneous means automatically spontaneous. Okay, and stereotyped means, you know, again and again if you do something. Okay, that is repeated reflexive. To so you should be able to make use. See, suppose, you know, whenever a man sits and gets up, you know, he is accustomed to be getting up in one particular way. Okay, some other person may be, you know, another. See, you should study those things. Okay, to avoid efforts required for recalling unnecessary information. Okay, see, these are all the activities of ergonomics. Now, the objectives or importance of ergonomics. Now, the primary objective is to improve human behavior and overall system performance by optimizing the integration of man and machine. See, the man and the machine system is there now. So now what you have to do is you have to optimize this man-machine system so that the human the system performance improves, because the human behavior has changed. If he feels it is comfortable, he responds positively, and thereby system performance is improved, and you know how you are optimizing your. So this is the primary objective. Now the secondary objectives are many. Okay, primary objective is only one. Secondary objectives are: ergonomics helps to study the man-machine relationship. It is important to enhance the man-machine relationship. It takes care of care of factors governing the physical and mental strain. Mental strain means, you know, is the human fatigue, mental fatigue, so as to obtain maximum satisfaction for the worker, which enhances productivity at the same time. It attempts to minimize the risk of injury, illnesses, accidents, and errors without compromising on the productivity. See, we have see the objective of ergonomics is to minimize the risks involved, to minimize the illnesses and accidents and other things, and the errors. And another objective of ergonomics is to improve the design of machine at the initial design stage itself, or later during the modification of an existing product. So, from the ergonomic point of view, okay, ergonomics reduces physical and mental stresses, thereby improving the quality of life. Working environment can be improved to increase the human efficiency. Then reliability, safety, etc. can be improved on low cost effective basis. These are the objectives of ergonomics. Now how this use of ergonomics is made for increasing the productivity. Now that's in industrial engineering, what you know, if you one word that is important for engineering, industrial engineering, is productivity, improving the productivity. Now productivity is a powerful tool to improve the. Why productivity should be improved? Because it improves the standard of living of the people. Now what is the standard of living? I told you before also, standard of living means, you know, how human beings in that country or in that state or in that city are living. You know, if you know how much of electricity, how many kilowatt hours each person on average uses, how much of water each person uses, how much of money each person is earning per month, or how many doctors are available for 1,000 people, or how many kilometers of road is available per 1,000 people, you know, all these such things, you know, gives us the measure of the standard of living. That's how you compare one country with another country. Okay, the standard of living. See, if your standard of living is improving, that means, no, you are making life more bearable and pleasurable. Of the living will be pleasure for people. Okay, otherwise, no, see, they will say, oh, what, it is a living is a, like a living in a hell here on the earth. Okay, it should not be like that. We should make, you know, life to live a pleasure. Okay, so standard of living should be improved, and to enhance the quality of work life. Is a standard of living for everybody, and for the working people, or for the people who are working in industries and other places, the quality of work life, QWL, this also should be improved. Okay, then ergonomics is concerned with the man and his working conditions. This we have been always talking, you know, so many times we have said already. Ergonomics increases the productivity by following measures. Oh, here some measures are given. One is improved working conditions. We have seen about this. Then improved behavior and increased morale of the worker. Is a behavior. You see, this is the psychology. If you are giving something, you know, the worker wants, you know, he will naturally positively respond to you. He'll be more willing to hear. He'll be more obedient. He'll be able to do his work well. Okay, and the morale of the worker will, you know, you it will increase, you know, he will take more interest and in doing the things, and you know, he will feel, you know, wo apnapan mehsoos karta hai, ye mera company aisa bole. See, he won't be telling them, supervisor, I am working for you in your company, you know. See, he will say, I am working in our company, you know. Everybody should be able to say like that, you know. If the morale is high, you know, they will own the company like that it is. Okay, then optimization of man-machine interface. Now, man is there, that is the operator or worker, and machine is there. Machine can be any machine, you know, from the computers onwards, from the mobile phones onwards, from to automobiles, cars, trucks, two-wheelers, or even our machines like lathe machine, milling machine, drilling machine, so any special purpose machines, anything it can be. See, these are the man-machine interfaces, so you have to optimize them. While designing their controls, their operations, their maintenance interfaces between man and machine in both working conditions and normal conditions and emergency conditions. Okay, you have to optimize. Then integration of man-machine with workplace. Integration of man-machine with workplace means men and machines interact simultaneously with the workplace and surrounding environment, which improves the efficiency and reliability of the work. Okay, so you see, ergonomics, you know, by use of ergonomics, the man machine workplace is integrated and thereby productivity is increased. Okay, next, fifth point is optimum design of machines and equipment facilities. Then effective plant utilization, because ergonomics is helping to increase the effective plant utilization, which also increases the productivity, and fatigue reduction. You see, the fatigue will be reduced, okay, for the worker or for the operator or user. Now, advantages, benefits of ergonomics. Productivity, this is the first thing. The first important thing is higher productivity. Second is more human comfort and less fatigue to the operator. Then third is better design of machines. Okay, naturally, because they are better only, you know, he is more comfortable. Okay, increased safety, you know, reduction of accidents and other things will happen because of the better use of ergonomics. And then better integration of man-machine system. Integration means, you know, if you should look, you know, man and machine as an integral part of thing, you know, not separately. You don't consider them separately. If they both are together, you know, with that viewpoint, if you design the systems, you know, then you will be able to design a better system. Okay, then reduced labor turnover. Labor turnover means, this word turnover, labor turnover means how many people are resigning and going away, leaving the job and going away, either resigning and going away, or they are abruptly stopping from coming to work. You know, though, you know, you are paying them money, you are paying them salary or wages, still they don't want to come. You know, why? Because, you know, something is not conducive to them. That's why they're not coming. Okay, reduce labor. See, so this is one parameter. You know, company should not be reputed that the people leave the company and go. That means, you know, something is wrong with that company. That is how people perceive it. Okay. Now, I think we will stop here for today. Now this chapter, this whole chapter, you know, they have given us 6 hours to cover in our syllabus. Okay, so let us see how many lectures we will require, because on online we are able to cover, you know, more syllabus compared to offline in the classroom. Okay, let us see how many lectures we'll consume. Today we will stop here. Okay, so thank you very much. We'll see you again. We'll meet in the next class tomorrow. Thank you.